Also tonight, it is a list that officials don't want you to see. A KCRA 3 investigation uncovers why some former drug users may not be going through their required testing. Here's the way it's supposed to work. Parents with drug habits often lose custody of their children. To get them back, those parents must stay clean and sober. But KCRA 3 has uncovered evidence that some parents in Placer County may be getting a free pass on those tests. David Bienick is live in Roseville with a story you will see only on KCRA 3. David.
Edie, good evening. This is the County Office of Health and Human Services, and around back by the loading docks, there's an entrance that former drug users are supposed to use when they come for their drug testing, urine testing. But as it turns out, one woman tells us tonight that the testing here has become a joke.
Oh, cheeky poo.
For several months last year, this woman in Placer County was forced to move out of her home because of an addiction to marijuana and methamphetamine.
Got to the point where I lost my children.
Now home again and reunited with her three young children, the woman, who doesn't want her face shown because she's worried speaking out could affect her case, had been coming here to the County Office of Health and Human Services in Roseville three times a week for drug testing.
Me being home with my children is all because of my negative tests.
Then, 5 weeks ago, the woman says she found this sign taped to the office's back door, telling her no one was available to witness the test, so she should just sign her name on a list as proof she was there and leave.
I thought maybe the tester was sick, you know, or they had a county holiday or something.
But then the woman came back day after day, week after week, and found the list still up and growing, several pages long. She says she's seen other people also signing in, sometimes under the influence, all operating on what's become a kind of honor system.
People are getting away with all kinds of stuff now. You know, they're out there just using because there's nobody to witness it.
And the kids that are at home with them, maybe?
Yeah, or not home with them, you know, or home by themselves while mom and dad are out getting high.
The head of county child welfare would not talk on camera, but told KCRA 3 by phone there's, quote, no problem, and that he's confident we're keeping our commitments to the courts. But when we started taking pictures of the list today, a county worker took it down.
It would be very inappropriate for you to publicize this.
Meanwhile, the woman says she's worried not only about people perhaps falling back into their drug habits, but also about what will happen to her when she goes back before a judge without any proof she's staying clean.
This could extend my case, yes.
The head of child welfare says tonight there is no shortage of people to administer the test. He says the sign is only put up when all of the testers are busy with other people. We asked how that could happen to this one woman 15 times in a row. He responded, she must be lucky. Live in Roseville, I'm David Bienick. Back to you.
And now she's trying to get clean. Thank you.